morning and a very warm welcome to our listeners of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. In our series of Desaratnalu, today we have with us Dr. G. Satish Reddy. Dr. Reddy is the Secretary of the Department of Defence Research Development, which spearheads India's indigenous development of defence research system and technologies. As we are entering and celebrating 75 years of independence, indeed, a very happy moment to talk to you, sir. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you, G. So nice. And to all the people who are listening, my namaskars.
Thank you, sir. Sir, what is the latest situation that we are, and are we prepared to face the third phase of COVID?
The government is taking a lot of steps to face any situation which may arise, whether looking at the oxygen requirements, are looking at the hospital's requirement, are looking at the supply of oxygen at various centers, which may not be hospitals, but which will be corona centers, or at homes also, and also any other equipment what is required. There have been continuous reviews which the various ministries, and none other than Honorable Prime Minister himself is continuously taking reviews on this. We are trying to make oxygen plants available all over the country, every district, and also even oxygen cylinders available, and all other equipment what is required also. The government is taking all the necessary steps and asking the respective departments to get geared up and get ready with whatever situation may come up.
Sir, during the second phase, our country faced severe scarcity of oxygen. What are the measures taken by the DRDO to solve this problem if necessity comes?
Honorable Prime Minister has directed us to come out with oxygen plants. Number of oxygen plants have been asked to be developed in the country. Industries have been geared up. PM CARES, Pradhan Mantrika PM CARES funds, has given orders for more than 1,200 numbers of oxygen plants. Out of that, 866 have been given to DRDO developed industries.
Mm-hmm.
And so these oxygen plants are being produced by the industries in large numbers, and they are going to every district. The hospitals have been identified by the health ministry in coordination with the state governments. And so those respective places, so the sites and the installation plan, everything is done. And the plants are going on. There are hundreds going to various districts across the country and being established at each and every important hospitals in the district. And also, again from PM CARES fund, oxygen cylinders, which are portable oxygen cylinders, have been given sanction. Mm-hmm. 1.5 lakhs of cylinders, which actually even control the oxygen instead of wasting the oxygen based on the SpO2 levels measured from the oximeters. And the oxygen is regulated based on that reading to the person. This cylinder can be at homes or corona care centers and other places. And so people can have this oxygen and without wasting much of oxygen. These cylinders are also being produced in large numbers by the industry now from PM CARES funds. And they're also being distributed to all the states. So that's how the oxygen thing is being taken care. Over and above the liquid oxygen and the tankers and supply of the liquid oxygen and all that, the other departments in the government are looking after that now.
Sir, could you please let us know about the anti-corona drug that is 2DG?
The drug what DRDO has developed for some other application in the early 2000 for some radio effective related effects, which was given the technology to Dr. Reddy Laboratories, that we attempted and tried for the efficacy of it against the coronavirus, which has proved to be very effective. And then we gone through the trials, and DCGI has approved the drug to be used on moderate to severe patients as an adjuvant therapy. And then it has been released, and it is in the market now. And now we have given it to many more industries.
Mm-hmm.
Already about 18 industries have approached. They're all taking the technology now. And we're trying to make sure that this drug is available large quantities across the country. Wherever there is a necessity, the drug will be available. And also, parallelly, we are doing a lot more studies on this also for using against various patients also. That's another thing. And so this drug, in the event of any other, again, the corona cases rising, the drug will be available in quantities.
Sir, does it work on different variants of corona like Delta, Delta Plus and so on?
It actually works on any virus. The way the drug functions is that it is like a glucose.
Mm.
A cell which is infected with the virus, you will be very thirsty and hungry.
Mm.
And it has to produce, and it will be producing a large number of such cells.
Mm-hmm.
So it actually consumes this glucose what we have given.
Mm-hmm.
But it is not actually a glucose.
Mm.
And so the particular cell becomes very inert. The reproducibility of that particular cell dies. So it can't produce anymore. So
mm-hmm.
the virus doesn't spread after you taking this. And so the body immunity system will be able to fight. So this is applicable for any virus. So it is applicable for any variant of the corona also. It will be working very effectively for all the variants of the corona as per the technology what has been brought into it, what we have seen it.
Sir, does it available in the open market? Like, are you supposed to go through some procedures like that?
It is actually on prescription of a doctor in the
hospital. Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm. So right now it is made available with the stockists,
mm-hmm.
and the hospitals can have it and use it for the patients under doctor's prescription.
Mm-hmm.
Right now it is not available in the free medical shops.
I see.
That also we are thinking how to make it available there.
Mm-hmm. Sir, could you please explain about hypersonic missiles?
The hypersonic missile technology is one way the missile will be traveling at more than 6 times of the speed of the sound.
Sound.
So it is more than about roughly 2 kilometers per second is the speed.
Mm-hmm.
And then the difficulty in that is to travel within the atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
See, a missile, when it travels at a lower altitude, it cannot be detected by the radars which are there in the other side of the boundary. And so the hypersonic cruise missiles have become very effective, or will be effective, as they travel at a very high speed, but then they're traveling at a lower altitude.
Mm-hmm.
So the technologies what are required in this, the propulsion technology, the materials technology, and various other control guidance and related things are very, very critical in that, which the country is working on. You have seen that last year we have done a demonstration flight.
Yes, yes.
HSTDV, which has gone through successfully. And so country is working on these technologies right now.
Sir, could you please explain about Nirbhay cruise missile?
Nirbhay is a subsonic cruise missile. That means it travels at a lower speed with respect to the sound.
Mm-hmm.
And it will be traveling at a very lower altitude. You must have heard about various cruise missiles in the world, like Tomahawk and other missiles.
Mm.
This, like that, is a cruise missile which travels at a lower altitude at a subsonic speed. And Nirbhay is developed by DRDO, which has been successfully flight tested.
Mm-hmm. So, Dr. Reddy, how about anti-drone technology developed by you, as we have seen some drones in Kashmir, Srisalam and so on?
DRDO has anticipated the issue arising out of the drones,
mm-hmm.
and so it has worked on the technologies,
mm-hmm.
and developed the anti-drone system, ADS,
mm-hmm.
and which actually we have demonstrated, and actually we have put it for the last year Republic Day, last year Independence Day, and this year Republic Day also.
Mm-hmm.
At Delhi,
mm.
and it has been demonstrated to various users.
Mm-hmm.
It has the detecting capability, and it also neutralizing without actually killing it.
Mm-hmm.
And then there is also hard killing capability also.
Mm-hmm.
So all the technologies have been developed in the country, and we have given the technology to Bharat Electronics Limited earlier about 7-8 months back, and now we are giving the technology to the private industries also. Already 3 industries have taken this, and so these systems will be available in large number in the country.
Mm-hmm. What is accuracy by detecting these anti-drone technologies and diffusing the anti-drones? What is the accuracy?
See, it is the accuracy part of it is, firstly, let me talk about the range.
Mm.
We should be able to detect at about 4-5 kilometers the drone system.
Mm-hmm.
And the accuracy has to be pinpoint.
Mm.
Otherwise, you won't be able to actually engage and neutralize the drone. So you have to actually track the drone, and you have to be at the center of the drone.
Mm-hmm.
So this particular accuracy, what is required in centimeters, is achieved by this anti-drone technology.
That's really great, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, can you give information about air independent propulsion system?
This is an important technology which is required by the submarines, and when their submarines are under below the water to keep them in for a longer duration. It's called air independent propulsion. You don't need to come up and breathe yourself, and everything is produced there itself, and then you can be staying underwater for a long period. This technology has been developed by our country now, a laboratory called NMRL in Bombay. That laboratory has developed this, and then it has demonstrated this technology for a longer period on the ground, and soon it will be getting integrated into our submarines.
Sir, nowadays we are talking about cyber warfare. Please let us know about the cyber warfare, please.
Cyber security is one of the important things for any nation now, and definitely for our nation also. There will be cyber attacks, and there will be a lot of issues related to the cyber security. And so a lot of work is going on in the country, whether it is in academic institutes or in the R&D organizations or in the startups also, in a big way. A lot of encouragement is being given to the startups, and they're also working on a lot of technologies which are required for the cyber defense and security of this country. And I'm sure that the country will be able to develop all these technologies which are required, which is developing and will be able to develop for the new threats which will be coming in the cyber security area.
So you have a lot of projects in your pocket. Then do you have sufficient funds to complete these projects?
Absolutely. The funds have been enhanced to DRDO in a big way. If you look at in the last about 7 years, it's almost doubled. The budget of DRDO is almost doubled. And so sufficient funds are available for all the projects which have been taken up. And that government is always continuously looking and monitoring at these requirements at appropriate stage. Whenever there is a requirement, I'm sure government will be taking the appropriate decision.
Sir, do you have any joint ventures, joint development programs with our friendly countries?
We have two programs which are running. One is the BrahMos system with Russia. Which we have developed the BrahMos as a jointly between Russia and India. And also we have another program, the MRSAM and LRSAM missiles, medium range surface-to-air missile with Israel. These two are the programs which actually we are working with two countries and developing the systems with a work share.
So what is this Prahar ballistic missile, sir? Prahar?
Prahar is a surface-to-surface ballistic missile of a short range, a lightweight missile, as a surface-to-surface battlefield missile. And so there are many systems. We are one of the people, few nations in the world, who have developed their own ballistic missile defense. And so we are actually now coming up and competing with the advanced nations, are coming up to the definitely advanced nations level in many technologies in the country. So advanced technologies are also being developed in the country in the various futuristic areas.
Sir, I'm sure you are all unsung heroes of our defense system. Having known that you have worked so much and you are well advanced in our defense system, it's really a pleasure to know you, sir.
Thank you. It's the work of the various laboratories in the country, and lots of scientists, their dedicated efforts, and with the continuous guidance from our Honorable Raksha Mantri, Honorable Prime Minister of the country, who have been giving us the directions and guidance, and the dedicated efforts of all the scientists across the country who are working on these systems.
Sir, do you like to give a message to our listeners of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh as we are entering and celebrating 75 years of independence?
75th Swatantra Dinotsava Sandarbhanga, Telugu Prekshalandariki Kuda Na Shubhakankshalu. 75 సంవత్సరాలు పూర్తయిన సందర్భంగా దేశం టెక్నాలజికల్ రంగంలో చాలా త్వరగా ముందుకు వెళ్లి ప్రపంచంలో ఉన్నటువంటి అగ్రదేశాలకు సరసన మనం నిలబడుతూ పూర్తి ఆత్మ నిర్భరతను సాధించి స్వదేశీయంగా అన్ని ఇక్కడే తయారు చేసుకుని ప్రపంచానికంతా కూడా పెద్ద ఎత్తున మన సామాగ్రిని ఎక్స్పోర్ట్ చేసి దేశం సుసంపన్నంగా ఉండేందుకోసం అందరూ కృషి చేయాలని చెప్పి మనసారా కోరుకుంటున్నాను.
So thank you very much, Dr. Reddy. It is my privilege to present your interview to our listeners. And Namaste, Jai Hind.